new developments in the search for Flight 370. Malaysian officials and the satellite company Inmarsat finally plan to release the raw satellite data to the public. This is the data that has been so central in determining the possible flight path and the current search area for the plane. Family members of the missing passengers have really been demanding this information since the beginning to allow for independent analysis in their mind. But when will the data be released? And most importantly, what is it going to show to the untrained eye? Let's discuss with our own Richard Quest. Richard, joining us from London this morning. So, Richard, this has been discussed for a very long time, has been pushed for. Inmarsat has said that they essentially have 14 data points, which is relatively little that they were able to get, and they will all be releasing it. What is it going to look like? Is the public going to be able to read into it?
Well, the data points are 14 lines in hundreds of lines of communications between the plane and the satellite. And what Inmarsat is doing and what the Malaysians are doing, they've extracted the crucial parts of the data, those that show what the plane was doing and why and where, and then they are going to put it into a package that will explain the various, if you like, theories, the sort of assumptions is perhaps the best word, the scientific and physical assumptions that they used to then work out the route of the plane. For those that actually want to know the nuts and bolts of the numbers, that will be included. So if you want to know the frequency, if you want to know the offset, if you want to know the actual time to the burst, that will be there. But if you want some explanation as well about how and why and the methods by which Inmarsat came to the data, they will also include that.